morning, everybody. We are here at FICCI for the annual seminar on shipbuilding, hosted in collaboration with the Indian Navy. And we have with us Mr. J.D. Patil, who heads the defense for FICCI. And of course, nobody knows his other introduction, which everybody feels we know, but then he's a Wholetime director with L&T. And till now, every time we were talking to him, we called him the head of L&T defense. But then now we know that he has a bigger picture and a bigger role to play. Welcome, Mr. Patil. I think today is the day when we are talking about shipbuilding. So we'd like to talk about, you know, L&T and being it's one of the primary shipyards. If I might delete one and say it is the primary private sector shipyard for shipbuilding. So how does it feel that, you know, you are at the top of an industry and you have all the business? So let's talk about your defense business.
I'll agree on some points, Sangeeta ji, and some things I don't agree. I don't have all the orders. All the same, we delivering well in time. I think just the headlines. As Larsen & Toubro, we've been delivering now for exactly 9 years. And over the 9 years since my first order in the defense shipbuilding, we delivered as of today 51 ships. And it's under the defense license, which we have since 2002. Obviously, it took some amount of time. By the time we were qualified to bid for RFPs. Past, obviously, we've been building huge amount of equipment and systems. And my equipment and systems today operate on nearly 70-75% of the naval fleet. If I add Coast Guard and naval thing both together, about 70% of the fleet. So with that kind of a range and development on equipment, systems, weapon systems, auxiliary systems, some amount of logistics on the helicopter side, life support system which have been going on ships. So all of us have been building this through completely indigenous R&D. And that differentiates us from the rest of the pack. So it's something which we started building from equipment systems. Beyond equipment systems, truly went on to doing our platforms. Uniqueness of Larsen & Toubro, all the 50 vessels that I talked of are indigenously designed and built. Till date, we have 4 contracts against which we are delivering this, and of course, some more ships which are in pipeline. Another 13 are in pipeline, and which obviously we are going to be delivering ahead of schedule. Each and every of what we delivered till date is one, indigenously designed, second, delivered ahead of time. So that's some kind of a uniqueness that one built. And this jungle of, I would say, gross underbidding, which is what has caused the industry a huge loss in terms of multiple players getting into bankruptcy. Larsen & Toubro stayed, is strategic for us. Biggest of the investment in industry we made. We built 2 shipyards and we operate 3rd, which is a government shipyard. With this scenario, when I start looking back, what is that we did right? We put in investment, right time, and essentially focused at defense shipbuilding. We are not confused in our mind to bring commercial shipbuilding. If I didn't have defense order, I may take some commercial order here or there. But our focus has been very, very clear. So we didn't build capacities that possibly would do 100 mm thick plates. Defense shipbuilding doesn't need thick. It's getting the great rigidity, good speed by controlling the weight and class of a ship. And that's exactly where we focused. We created completely new hull forms, which obviously earlier the hull form used to be done only by Indian Navy. The DGND actually does the hull forms. But in our case, we created completely new hull forms and built ships on those new hull forms, qualified them. And that's been the kind of a journey. When you do your own design, you actually take a little longer by the time you build the first ship. It's very easy to get a design from somewhere else and start on that day. The flip side, you could have gained some amount of time, but the flip side is you remain dependent because you're never going to have your own knowledge, never going to be able to make changes, modifications. So doing design in-house, like the entire defense sector of Larsen & Toubro, that's something which we started doing with even the warships. Of course, what we do on the underwater program is a shining example of what levels of indigenization one can attain and achieve. And that's essentially something which what we did. Right investments, right kind of approach that let's do design and build. But that's the time you control 90% of the cost. That 5-10% of the design controls the 95% of cost and speed. So notwithstanding, we take, by the time we start building the first vessel, we take longer as compared to having bought the design. But once you start, you gallop and gain it faster. Obviously, systems make huge difference in trying to do this. And the systems in this case is L&T Shipyard is 4.0. We got into completely 3D design in virtual reality 20 years back, when it was not even being talked about by most of the industry about Industry 4.0, which is fashionable word, people talk about it today. But Larsen & Toubro invested in the digital technologies exactly 2 decades back. And that's exactly where we see that we may be the slow starter. It's like the slow and steady certainly wins. Gallop, you start facing hurdles. Because you don't control the knowledge, you don't control your own destiny. And that's essentially what has made difference for Larsen & Toubro in shipbuilding. At FICCI, what we actually start doing is start monitoring what all is happening in the whole sector. And then obviously one is constructively critic in terms of telling the government what has been happening, does something needs a change, does something needs to, I mean, the many good things which the previous government did and this government is continuing. I'm saying the current regime itself from 2014 onwards. Till 14, we never saw a level playing field. 14 onward, we started seeing sizable level playing field getting in. Ask me, is it fully level playing? It is not. And there are many issues on which we still actually ask the government to make it completely level playing field. And that's a chamber which actually takes it up. And those issues essentially are not individual, corporation or company. One deals with, when you are dealing as a chamber, one deals with industry-wide issues which essentially would make difference. Government of India very rightly, as a result, asked us where is the level playing gaps. And as a result, they actually allowed that whatever you have in terms of taxation regimes, let's put the same thing for the foreigners. So foreigners' supplies started getting custom duty taxed. Indian supplies were always getting taxed in terms of those days the excise as well as the sales tax and now all GST. The scene we have seen is 3-4 years, this has caused enormous amount of budget shrinkage. And this budget shrinkage is visible. Last 3 years there is nothing new and the revenue expense or the committed liabilities in capital have been on the rise and the fresh money available has been lower and lower. And that's exactly where we see very positively that this year, without cutting the growth in the budget, whatever the number was talked about, 1,04,000 crores, government said only on import which Government of India is doing. So right now fact is we're buying fighters, we're buying some warships, we're going to get the next nuclear submarine. Now we're going to get the S-400. Now each of those mega programs which are going to be imported, there's no point government actually paying custom duty on that where there's no level playing issue with the private sector. So what we see very positively at FICCI today is government is saying wherever I am directly buying, it's through government to government deals. Why am I spending that money? Because that is where the defense budget gets cut down. So this saving on the defense budget, as I see because of the custom duty, will save the government on an average 6,000 crore starting this year. Now, where does this 6,000 crore go? And this 6,000 crore, we believe, will now move into the new programs. And that's essentially we see that the budget's remaining same as what was in the interim budget. 6,000 crore is extra for the new program. So we are bullish as a chamber that Ministry of Defense this year should be able to conclude anywhere between 40 to 60,000 crore programs more than what they would have done otherwise under the interim budget. And that's to my belief, is a positive way moving forward. Government is seized of the fact that, yes, the taxation is far higher here. When it's imported, even today, you only have the basic custom duty. all of us pay GST, which is far higher. So obviously there is some amount of corrections that need to be done. Between public sector and private sector, which is a perennial point with the chambers, as the chambers we keep raising, and these issues obviously need to be sorted out, because it's not going to be only public sector who will take it forward. Because there is a certain growth rate, if we see historic growth rate of public sector revenue growth versus the total country's requirement, there is a sizable gap and it's widening. So this gap essentially has to be filled up by private companies, whether shipbuilding, whether in other sectors. Shipbuilding is extremely important because we heard the Navy Chief saying that per labor in a MOD or a private shipyard where MOD has placed an order creates a multiplier of 6.2. Beyond those workers, there's far more of economic multiplier which actually goes in the economy. So if, let's say, Indian Navy places, just to name, 1 lakh crore of orders this year, they only have to disburse 10,000 crores. But that 1 lakh crore creates, to my mind, between 10 lakh crores of actual GDP creation, and that actually provides jobs. So if one has to look at jobs for our youth, jobs for higher skills, much more white-collar job as compared to the blue-collar jobs, in comparison, better mix, which is moving towards that, with a country which is educating all our youth, that's where the opportunity lies, and that's where obviously in terms of times to come, we should be doing far better as long as Government of India puts in more. Competitively speaking, we see our immediate neighbors today are cutting down on their land forces, and the cutting down is not small. It's 35-40% of the land forces budgets are being cut, and that money directly is getting today diverted to the marine and the land, the naval forces, and those forces actually is creating them the sovereignty sort of, or when they say that we are controlling certain amount of regimes, so those are something which obviously if India has to match, India has to do far more, and that's exactly we see way going forward.